According to Statistic.com, Nike's revenue for the first quarter 2020 reached $10.7 billion compared to $9.965 billion during the same period last year. Footwear revenue rose to $6.5 billion in quarter one, and from North America alone, Nike generated $2.67 billion. And by the time you're watching this, the chances that you are wearing a pair of Nikes are not that low either. This is Nike's success story. Hey everyone, and welcome to Booked, where we inspire others with inspiring stories. In today's video, we are going to go over the success story of Nike and talk about its founder, Bill Knight. So make sure to watch this video till the end, because we are going to share with you the books that the founder read and wrote along his amazing journey. Books that changed his life and that may change yours. But before getting to the middle of today's video, make sure to subscribe to the channel. Since ancient times, civilizations sought different ways to increase human comfort and improve the different clothing industries. One of the industries that received attention over centuries was the shoe industry. From one century to another, shoemakers looked for ways to improve their end product in order to have better feedback from their customers and achieve as most comfort as possible.
They're not natural to the feet. Your feet are not made to wear big fat shoes like that.
And as any other industry, there has to be a game-changing individual who would revolutionize the way customers and creators looked at a particular niche. And when it comes to the shoe industry, there's no better example than Phil Knight, also known as the founder of Nike. With that being said, let's get right into our video. Early life. On the 24th of February, 1938, a particular event would represent the first sparks of a series of circumstances that would revitalize the shoe industry. It was on that day that Philip Hampson Knight was born. Phil Knight was born in Portland, Oregon. He is the son of Loda Hatfield Knight and William W. Knight, also known as Bill Knight. His father was a lawyer, politician, and a newspaper publisher. When it comes to his father, it is said that he was not the child-spoiling kind. In fact, there's a particular story that says that one day, Phil Knight asked his father for a summer job at his newspaper. To Phil's surprise, his father refused, but instead, he went to the rival newspaper company, the Oregonian, and worked there. And whenever he finished his work, he would run back the 7 miles to his home. Phil grew up in a typical Portland neighborhood, and he attended Cleveland High School. Later on, Phil Knight graduated from the University of Oregon with a degree in journalism in 1959, and from Stanford Graduate School of Business with a master's degree in business administration in 1962. While in Oregon, Phil Knight ran track under his coach, Bill Bowerman. Phil was a middle distance runner at his university. His personal best was 1:13 per 1 mile. Phil was indeed into sports, and in 1977, he founded an American running team with his coach and Jeff Hollister called the Athletics West. Phil was also a sports reporter for the Oregon Daily Emerald. After graduating from Oregon, Knight enlisted in the Army and served for 8 years, one active duty and 7 as part of the Army Reserve. Afterwards, Phil Knight worked as a certified public accountant with Coopers & Lybrand and then with Price Waterhouse. Then he decided to switch professions and he worked as an accounting professor at Portland State University. If you haven't noticed by now, Phil Knight did not take one particular career path since the very beginning. Instead, he kept switching over and over. This allowed him to test different kinds of professions until that one day came when he stumbled on that one thing that would turn into his commitment, the shoe industry. Career development. Needless to say, Phil Knight was raised by the mantra of finding a job by himself. But while in Stanford, he published a particular paper that would spark his interest in running shoes. His paper was called, "Can Japanese Sports Shoes Do to German Sports Shoes What Japanese Cameras Did to German Cameras?" Phil Knight had a specific ambition. His plan was simple: to bring to the American market high-quality shoes for a low price. And the country that he intended to import from was Japan. Knight packed his bags and went for a trip around the world. And in November 1962, he decided to shop in Kobe, Japan, a place that Phil Knight described as his MBA 62 graduation remarks as friendly, but most importantly, as a place where many things were affordable, including running shoes. While in Kobe, Phil heard of an interesting man with an interesting perspective to running shoes. This man was called Onitsuka, and his shoes were so impressive, they made Phil called Mr. Onitsuka. Onitsuka's brand was called Tiger, and Phil made sure to secure Tiger distribution rights to Western US by the end of his meeting with Onitsuka. After a year, the first Tiger shoe samples were shipped to Phil. When he received them, he managed to mail two pairs to his coach and friend Bill Bowerman at Oregon University. Little did he know that Bowerman would later become the co-founder of Nike. When Bowerman received the shoes, he ordered them. But most importantly, he offered Phil his partnership in order to provide design ideas. Phil agreed and they became partners on the 25th of January, 1964. The partners put $500 to start their company. This date not only represents the partnership of Phil Knight and Bill Bowerman, but it also represents the birth date of Blue Ribbon Sports, BRS, which later will turn into Nike. You might think that Phil and Bowerman would think now of renting a store in which they would sell their shoes. In fact, Knight's first sales were of his green Plymouth Valiant. 5 years after the creation of Blue Ribbon Sports, Phil left his accounting job, and 2 years later, the company hired Jeff Johnson. Jeff Johnson is not only known as Nike's first employee, but he's also the one who suggested the name Nike after the Greek-winged goddess of victory. Phil and Bowerman liked the name, and Nike was announced in 1978. As for the symbolic swoosh logo, it was designed by Carolyn Davidson for only $35. Little did she know that later on, she would be given some Nike stocks for her contribution in the creation of the brand. What made the company flourish even more was the fact that John Anderson won the Boston Marathon while wearing Nike shoes. Jimmy Connors won the Wimbledon and US Open while also wearing a pair of Nikes. Henry Rono set 4 track and field records wearing Nike shoes as well. And most importantly, some Boston Celtics and Los Angeles Lakers basketball team members were all wearing Nikes. But here's what's interesting about Nike. Nike indeed was growing exponentially for more than a decade. It was indeed giving so much value to its customers, and this can be clearly seen in its first commercial, when they highlighted that their products focus on speed and safety. But one day, the company did one mistake that would alter its perception of the shoe industry. Phil had to make one decision that would later on become one of the most influential ideas as far as branding and marketing is concerned. Nike misjudged the aerobics market. After a series of problems related to this decision, Phil, who was by that time the founder, CEO, and chairman of the company, decided to focus more on the consumer rather than the product. The company became consumer-oriented. His decision altered Nike's branding strategy completely. The product is not the central and focal point anymore. It's the consumer. And wherever consumer is king, the brand becomes the monarchy. Achievements. Talking about Phil Knight's achievements one by one will surely take us from one other separate video, but it only seems fair to note some of them in today's episode in order to showcase what this legend has achieved so far. First and foremost, it is important to note that Phil Knight held the 17th spot on Forbes 400 Wealthiest Americans of 2020, the 25th spot on Forbes Billionaires of 2020, the richest man in Oregon on Forbes' list, the richest person in every state for 2019, and the richest person in Oregon in Forbes' list of the richest person in America's 50 largest cities of 2016. Phil is now the chairman emeritus of Nike. And for those of you who do not know what a chairman emeritus means, it means that this particular person has a similar rank to the position, yet he is not doing the same job as the chairman. Phil's net worth is estimated by $39.2 billion in 2020. And while in Nike, he made some personal relation with some of the most famous athletes ever, such as Michael Jordan and Tiger Woods. In addition to the billions of dollars that Phil Knight and his wife donated to charities, Phil's memoir, Shoe Dog, became rated the 5th bestseller on the New York Times. Book recommendations. Every successful millionaire has an amazing love story with books. And what follows is Phil Knight's recommendation of books for those who are seeking the same greatness that Phil has achieved. The links to the books are provided in the description box down below. Shoe Dog by Phil Knight by Phil Knight. This is one of the books read by billionaires such as Bill Gates and Warren Buffett. Phil Knight, Shoe Dog is one fabulous memoir which narrates the journey of Nike and highlights its struggles and evolution, as well as some personal picks from the author's life story. Imagine It Forward, Courage, Creativity, and the Power of Change by Beth Comstock. One amazing book about how to face life roadblocks, how to overcome them, and how to find the necessary courage to alter your life path and reach better destinations. Bowerman and the Men of Oregon, the story of Oregon's legendary coach and Nike's co-founder, by Kenny Moore. This particular book recreates the life of Bill Bowerman, the co-founder of Nike, through the eyes of the Olympic marathoner Kenny Moore. It highlights the achievements of Bowerman and showcases his greatness when it comes to running. Book of Five Rings, The Classic Guide to Strategy, by Miyamoto Musashi. The writer of this book is not your typical author. He's a swordsman. This book inspired a lot of businessmen throughout history thanks to its unique way of conceptualizing strategy and tactics by referring to swordsmanship strategy. The Analects, by Confucius. This book is a pure source of wisdom. It represents a collection of the ancient sayings and ideas that were attributed to the ancient Chinese philosopher Confucius. This book has been referenced in Phil Knight's memoir and should be read by everyone who seeks to dive and explore the ideas of Confucius. Conclusion. From the points that we've mentioned in this video, it seems fair to admit that Mr. Knight's life is one of those that you would like to narrate to yourself every night before going to bed. The success that this man achieved and the impact that he and his company had in the shoe industry is truly something inspirational, and all future entrepreneurs should think twice before thinking of hardships, since this man had literally started from scratch, tried different things, and had an ambition that he believed in and turned into a reality.